You need to try to relax. You're making me anxious. There's no way Terry has answered you. They're gonna get over it, you know. Wait, what did he just do? Despite it only being a few minutes since he texted. You're making me anxious. Ko stared hard at the screen as though he was trying to will a new message to appear. As your words sank in, he forlornly let his gaze fall to the side. Ko's voice came out so small and quiet that you would have missed it if he hadn't already taken your full attention. Sorry. You nod slowly. Ko closed his eyes, letting out a sigh as though trying to clear away pressure from inside his chest. Glancing at your own phone in vain, you considered sending a text message too, if that would even help. This was making you feel all twisted up. You could see the same sort of discomfort on Cove's face. There was something consoling him in that, at least. Words drifted from his mouth like a feelable breeze. It'll be fine. It'll be fine. It's gonna be okay. Yeah. You can hear in both your voices how much you wanted to give and receive reassurance. You tried to believe the sentiments, weak as they were. Should we? What do we even say if we do hear from one of them? His pacing resumed as he attempted to answer his own question. We should probably tell them to talk to each other, so instead of only us, maybe. He slowly came to another halt, like a gear winding down. We should find out Terry's side of the story. We should just confirm Miranda and let up with Terry. I don't know. We should only tell them to work it out between themselves. That's it. You wondered why you always had to come up with things. You didn't say anything. We should find out Terry's side of the story, honestly. Nothing could be done until you knew what she thought of this. That much was certain. Cove nodded slightly in agreement. For 7 minutes, you both remained there in silence, drowning in your thoughts. Eventually, Cove turned around. I'm gonna text Terry that we already know what's going on. Maybe she'll have an easier time talking to us because she won't have to pretend or explain. Yeah, that might be the only way to get her attention. You can't do that. Miranda didn't say it was alright to admit she talked to us. You felt way too overwhelmed to know what to say. I think you're pushing too much. It's not a good idea, Cove, not at all. Why are you so fixated on this? Yeah, I feel like that's the only way to get maybe Terry to talk to us. I would feel bad for Miranda though, but I feel like it's the only one. With the two of you on the same page, he steeled his gaze to prepare for taking his next step. Ko's fingers worked furiously yet carefully. He was giving his full attention to his words. He sidled up next to him and looked, trying to watch what he was writing. Ko rapidly typed out, "Hey Z, I really want to talk to you. Miranda told us what happened. Please reply back." And sent. It was done. We'll just have to see what happens now. Quietly, he felt nervous. I wish you weren't so concerned with everyone else's feelings, but mine. That's cringe. It'll definitely be fine, right? I really hope she gets us back so soon. Great. Can we do something else now? You're being dramatic. I hate that. I really hope she gets back to us soon. Me too. From just his face, you could tell that wasn't going to happen. That wasn't going to do much for him. He was going to be stuck thinking about this until Terry replied. That was something else you had in common. A small noise escaped his lips. All the frustration at the situation crumbled away from his face, and he spoke softly. Thanks, Z. I'm glad it's not just me with all this happening. I mean, she did call me, so if you didn't show up, this would be a me problem. I'm just saying. Cove took one last look at his phone and then put it away. His effort at a smile was meager, but it's earnest. Okay. You can just forget about it for a while. Terry will talk to us when she wants to. He smiled just a little bit. Finally, that sounds good to me. I'd like to be alone for a while. Could you leave? He suddenly nodded back. That sounds good to me. And you meant it, exhaling some of your own concern away. The last thing you wanted was to fight with Cove. A silence stretched on in what felt like hours, but it likely wasn't that long before there was a knock on your bedroom door and Mom peeks in. I just wanted to check in on you. Oh, Cove, when did you get here? And when she saw your morose expression, she opened the door all the way, and the question was dropped. Mom was standing there as well. She slipped past her wife to come inside your space.
Everything okay?
What's with the long faces? Are you both okay? We're okay. Your body language could not have contradicted you more strongly, and you knew it. You couldn't even lift your eyes off the floor as though the weight of your worry was dragging you your head down. Miranda called earlier. She and Terry are fighting, but none of us know what's going on with Terry. Your parents exchanged a meaningful look, though its meaning was lost on you.
I'm so sorry.
To hear there's trouble with your friends, sweetie. Is there anything we can do to help? Out of the corner of your eye, you saw Cove rub his arm awkwardly, unable to add anything. No, we're just waiting to see if Terry calls or texts, or if Miranda does. Well, we can at least help you take your mind off things while you're waiting.
Yeah.
Another great idea, Lonnie. You can get the whole gang together for some quality time. Mom gave you a soft smile and added, this'll be good, especially since it might help make up for what happened at the farmer's market. Yes, it'll be wonderful. I'll go see what Liz is up to right now. Excited, she fluttered a few steps away and then stopped. She pivoted on her heels and raised a single finger, flashing a big smile at Cove.
No trouble.
And of course, Cliff will be welcome too. Knowing your family was always there for you, that couldn't be underestimated. In fact, it meant everything to you that your mom cared so much. I really appreciate this. Thank you. Yeah, thanks. That's nice of you.
You're welcome.
Don't sweat it. Not so kiddos leave things to us. Just relax and we'll call when it's all together. You nodded and your mom's dispersed from now, springing into action for their impromptu get-together. You flopped down on your bed, feeling like you could sink into it and disappear. Cove, meanwhile, took a spot on a chair off to the side. You sighed at the same time, and Cove's mouth pulled into a bent smile at that. He gave his phone another quick check, and his eyebrows furrowed. Still nothing? Yep. This is crap, huh? Yep. Cove chewed the inside of his cheeks as if to mimic the stress that was clearly eating away at him. Cove, what's wrong? What's really wrong? One disagreement doesn't make you act like this. That got a pointed pause in his movement. Cove was carefully trying to put his thoughts together. He spoke in a fragile voice. I mean, he did come over here, and we got interrupted, so we don't know why he came over. People you care about, when they're unhappy with each other, there's nothing you can do. At least when you're in a fight yourself, you have some responsibilities, some control over it. I wish...
So...
It didn't have to happen, but that is impossible, so... Oh well, I guess... His attempt at giving a nonchalant shrug after that was pitiable. Yeah, it makes me feel horrible too. True, but you're right that it can't be helped. It's whatever. Other people can do what they want, right? You stay silent. True, but you're right. It can't be helped.
I know.
He replied like he can barely muster the strength to speak. Well, we just have to focus on things we can impact, or at least try. He turned to Cove, hoping your eyes conveyed the message you were feeling better than your words. A gentle nod told you that they did. It was a question you had to ask. Is it because of what happened with your parents? Cove ran a hand through his hair, a strained smile spreading across his lips for him. This pain struck close to his heart. Just as quickly as it had come, his smile was gone, lost in Mrs. Faraway gaze. Yeah, you got it. It's like my parents. Despite knowing him for so many years, Cove had never spoken of the years before he moved to Sunset Bird, before his parents separated in any detail. He whispered his thoughts distantly, almost unconcerned with whether you could hear them or not.
That's...
They used to fight all the time. I think they got along when I was a baby. I mean, they had to have wanted to be with each other at some point, but when I was old enough to remember anything, it was already bad. There was always something wrong, and I could never help. I just wanted them to be happy. You tried to imagine your mom's breaking up, and the very idea scared you, but Coven endured that for real. I'm sorry. Z.
Don't worry about it.
It's okay. Despite that revelation, Cove gazed reassuringly at you. It's not like that anymore. Things are so different now. I don't even really think about it. Again, the sorrow reasserted itself. What he continued, you could barely hear him. But I guess it's pretty obvious. I haven't forgotten either. You tried to smile for him. You crossed the room and took his hand. Went over and placed a hand on his shoulder. You hugged him. Yeah, I should hug him. You crossed the room, picking up a little bit of speed, and Cove's eyes widened. He shot out of the chair and stood waiting for you with a nonplussed look. When you collided into him, wrapping your arms around his middle and knocking the air out of his lungs, all mystery was gone. Cove squeaked.
Oh.
Returned the gesture longingly, exhaling You pressed your cheek into the warmth of his chest. The tension stuck inside you, released like a river flowing into the ocean that was Cove. The firmness of his hug told you Cove didn't plan on letting you go anytime soon. You both needed the comfort and closeness for just a little bit longer. When you finally did, the two of you took a seat again, but this time side by side on your bed. Today was a lot, huh? Yeah, it was. He sat there contently. You leaned there again. I'll lean. resting the side of your head onto his shoulder, you glanced up at his face. Cove watched you affectionately. In that gentle gaze, you finally felt like something, like everything was going to be okay. No matter what happens, we can make it work. His mouth pulled into a bent smile at that. You chuckled, resting your hand comfortably back on his shoulder.
Me too.
And for a while, you stayed like that. A comfort quiet fell between you and the sun fell with it. The warming calm ended when Cove gasped sharply. He spun half, expecting to find him nursing an injury, but instead found him staring straight ahead. What?
Oh my god.
I think my phone just vibrated. Check it out. Right. He patted his pocket, fumbling in his panic, and yanked the phone out. The force of the action nearly catapulted the device out of his grip entirely, but he caught it just in time. His eyes honed in on the screen. It's Terry, thank God. She says she's sorry. He looked back at you, eyes wide as his nerves started to fray once more. What should I say? I don't know. Give it a second, I need to think. Tell her to call us. Ask her what's going on. Okay. He glanced to you a shaky smile as he began to type. You suspected that he had a similar thought himself, but wanted the reassurance of a second opinion. Cove's phone buzzed nearly as soon as the message was sent. It's Terry again. She's talking to us. She's asked about what Miranda said, but wait. You leaned in, watching the conversation unfold on Cove's screen.
Right.
She's gonna actually call. Cove held his breath as he waited. Though he was good with people, he'd never been at ease managing conflicts. I think it's kind of fun. I probably shouldn't have enjoyed this and that. His phone rang out. Cove jammed the answer button. He switched the phone into speaker mode, allowing you to participate in the conversation. But despite his immediate reaction, his voice lacked the same resolve when he spoke. Hey. It was tentative, a white flag fluttering in the wind. Z is here too. Hi, we've been worried about you.
Hey.
Buddies. Terry's voice was barely recognizable without her usual quick patter and energy.
Are you okay?
I don't know. Probably not. Cove tensed, but his free hand coiling into an anxious fist. Can you talk to us about what happened? Don't you already know? Miranda explained some of it, but it doesn't make sense to us. You heard Terry sigh over the phone as she unburdened herself. Pretty much I was at Randy's house. We decided to watch some movies. She's super like that. I'd never even seen before. Turns out there's lots of those. We watched one, then another, and another. We were having so much fun. Each time she finished, she had another one to share with me. I didn't really think about this time. I only wanted to say yes to Randy and watch her movies. She spoke wistfully, but her words were full of affection. It was Randy, you know. I wasn't thinking about my schedule or what time it was. I get it. Then I finally saw the time. And, oh no, it was way too late. I already knew I couldn't stay. She took a deep breath, her voice becoming softer when she resumed talking. I was so stressed out. I just couldn't deal with it. Miranda wanted to help. She kept coming up with ways to make it better and trying to figure out why I was so upset and stuff. I was trying to answer her questions, and there were so many, but I couldn't really answer all of them, and I didn't even know why some of her ideas didn't work with me. It made my head ache. I still had the first problem. And Randy's there trying to help, blasting all these questions and suggestions at me faster than I could even think. She gulped audibly, sniffling. I got frustrated and told her to just leave me alone, but then she wanted to talk about why I wanted that. And we started to have a fight in the kitchen and woke Randy's dad up. We told him about how I wanted to go home, but my parents gonna get me, so Mr. Eckert offered to do it. That's nice of him. Terry groaned. I know. I accepted because I definitely couldn't stay then, not after throwing a racket and turning it into a big deal. But I feel awful and embarrassed. Why did I yell at Randy and hurt her feelings? I made her tadly sleep by waking him up and having to drive me home. What do you say after that? I have no idea. I don't know where to start, and I don't want to make it worse by saying the wrong thing and fighting again. So, I'm not talking. Terry, Randy isn't mad that you didn't want to stay or that you fought. She just wants to feel like you can talk to her. I mean, you can say whatever you want. She'll listen. Not talking to her at all is pretty much the only wrong way to go about it. Terry lamented him mournfully on the other end of the line, but he had a point. Unless she faced Miranda again, there would be no resolution. He looked at Cove hunched over the phone, staring pensively into it, and searched for a solution. This couldn't be solved with the other key party missing, but what if you brought them in? Your phone was still free.